presented by Church Tech U. It's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to switch between live video sources with macros. And another bonus. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I help you learn all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've wanted a way to switch between cameras without putting the live video source directly on a slide so that it always changes when the slide changes, then go ahead and give me a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the little bell icon. Okay, so when they added macros to ProPresenter 7 in version, I want to say 7.5 or 7.6, they made it possible to do this fun little thing. And by doing that, they also made it possible to basically treat ProPresenter like a very rudimentary video switcher. Now, there are ways to get more functionality, but this is, I'm just going to cover this. If you have just a couple of different cameras, you want to bring them into ProPresenter and switch between them without affecting the main UI of ProPresenter. So let's head over to my computer and we'll take a look. So, the first thing we need to do is we need to make sure that we have multiple cameras added as video sources. So I've already done that, and if you need to know how to do it, I'm just going to go over the highlights real quick, and that is we start up here, ProPresenter Preferences Inputs. Now, it needs to be NDI, siphon if you're on a Mac, or a capture device. So like the Declink Duo 2 is a perfectly fine one. The Blackmagic recorder, the 3G recorder is the latest version. That one works too. There are others, but those are ways that you can bring that in. So you'll see that I've added a few. Another thing that I've added is this is a USB webcam. Probably most of the time you're not going to want to use a USB webcam in ProPresenter, but there might be occasions. So you click on the plus button and then you choose from the drop down menu here which of these you want to add. So that's how you can bring in a video source. Then once you've done that, you can click on video input down here, click on the plus button, and then you can add them one at a time. So I've got six of them. Let me add that one just to show you how that's done. And right now, I can just click on any of these at any time. But there's no keyboard shortcut to go to these. And that's a bit of a bummer. I can drag them up onto any of these slides, right? And then as soon as I click on this, then that particular input would be live. And if that's what you want to do, that's fine. I just like the ability to change more dynamically. So that's why I think we ought to do this. So let's head over here to macros and hit the plus button here. And I can add a macro. So let's call this camera one. And now I can right click on it, add action, and do video input. So let's say it's this one right here. So now anytime I click on this, or I could just drag it, I could just drag it over here onto a slide. It's hard to see because the color is dark, but it's there. Or I could have that start with the calendar action, any of that. But there's another way, and this is the kind of bonus thing that I was talking about. So if we go into Companion, so if you download Bitfocus Companion, now the reason that most people download it is because they've got a Stream Deck like the one that I have here. I've got the cable routed, so I can't really show it to you very well, but it kind of looks like this. So what I can do, if I have, right now it's a beta version, or at least last time I checked, it could be that Dan has upgraded that. The ProPresenter, the guy who created the module for ProPresenter inside of Companion, is a member of the ProPresenter users group. So could be that it's now a shipping version. But once you do that, then you can add a button that switches between macros. So let's actually do that. I'm going to click on clear capture. Let's click on this one, and I'm going to change that to camera one. Okay, just changing the name. I can tweak that however I want to. And now instead of having this do this, I'm gonna go ahead and delete that. I'm gonna click add and go down to ProPresenter 7. ProPresenter on my 16-inch thing. So let's go down, and where is it? Ah, trigger macro. So I can do that now. Click down here, and I find my macro. I think it was actually this one. It might need to be re-added so that it shows up here. But now, on my Stream Deck, I can, by clicking on the Camera 1 button, I can switch to Camera 1. So that is totally independent from the user interface of ProPresenter 7. So you could have someone different switching between cameras while someone was running ProPresenter for lyrics. So that person doesn't need to think about things, or, they have a separate UI on the side. Bitfocus Companion is free. The Stream Deck to run it, you couldn't you it is possible to run it in the emulator here. So I could go to page one and do it there. But it's much better to do it with the Stream Deck, and you can have that control inside ProPresenter 7 and have the ability to switch between cameras. I just showed you how to add one. You can add multiples with Companion and ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, I bet you'd like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to TDM.fyi/pro7quick, put in your name and email address, and then I'll make a login for you for that course for free. You can take it whenever you want. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.